Hey everyone, it's Nelson Miller here with PA Creative, and I have another tutorial here related to Divi, and we're going to be using CSS to style and customize the back to top button in Divi. I'm also going to show you how you can do that easily with our plugin, the Divi Assistant. So I'm going to give you the two options, whether you want to use code snippets or use really easy settings in the plugin. So let's get started. All right, come over to the blog post. And basically, we are going to have snippets to style the background, maybe the color or the padding, the size, the icon. You might want to replace the icon with a different icon to match your styles on your site, or even add text, or even move the icon in from the side because it's kind of right at the side, or add a hover effect. So those four things. This is an important user experience thing. I hate when I go to a website and it doesn't have a back to top button. Oh, it drives me crazy. So I'm not sure if you like me or not. Actually, I just noticed on the side of my screen, I have mine a little off the side. I don't know how many like pixels that would be, but you can see it's a little off the side. Then I like even move it up a little and have a shadow that comes on hover. So that's just a little example. So first of all, you need to enable the back to top button in Divi. That's great that Divi comes with this feature. You'll have to certainly activate that first. So, you know, go back into theme options. I don't think it's enabled by default. So you may need to come in here and actually enable that. And you know how it works. So basically, when you're at the top of your screen, you will not see it. It will only start to appear after you've scrolled down. So if your website page is like really short, you actually may never see it on that page. So it's only going to appear after, I don't know, certain point, right? And you know how it works. You know, you just click it and come back to the top. But it by default, you know, it's a little boring. You know, it's gray and it has like a white, I'm not sure what that icon is called. But anyway, let's get to it. We have snippets here for each aspect of this. So you can look in here. I have some information about where to add CSS code if you're not familiar with that. All right, so the first snippet here is about replacing the icon. So, you know, you may not want the default icon. Like I said, it may not quite match your branding or styling, or maybe you have a different kind of icon other areas on your site, like an arrow that's just different, right? So here's how you can do that. You can see here I have a forward slash and then 2-1 in the quotes, right? And that's in the content. And basically, this is, we're already using the Elegant Themes icon font family. So basically, go to this website. It's Elegant Themes website. And then you can look here. So you can see that 2-1. It has like this and hashtag X. But just take the number 2-1. And then do it like this here, /2-1. And that will be the icon. So let me show you that. I'll copy this. And I'm just going to, you can see how the default icon is. I'm going to put this into, let me do it this way. I'm going to put it in theme options. So I'm going to put it there and then save, okay? Now I will refresh my page to show you that. And you can see it turned red and it's a different arrow. And it also moved it down. And I'll explain that. It moved it down. Now, if that was all you were going to do, come in here and take out that top 3 pixels in relative position and save. I'll explain why, but now I'll just refresh it. Basically, it was moving it down a little. If you're just using the icon like that, you don't need that, but I'm actually gonna undo it. If you are doing the next step, where we're adding text to the button, you do need that to align the icon in the text. So hope that made sense. But this next one is adding text. Sometimes you'll see this. It'll say scroll to top or back to top, or I feel like there's another one I'm not thinking of, just like top or scroll up, or I don't know. But like back to top is kind of what you would think it's a back to top button. So you can see in the content of the after pseudo class, content, we're putting the words back to top. Makes sense, right? We're literally adding those words into the icon. Think of it kind of like that. And then since we're adding text, you have to declare the font family is Open Sans or whatever font family you need. Now you also can declare the font line height and the font size. And then we're doing this position because we're trying to get the text and icon to line up. And then margin left because when we're using the icon and the text together, we have to adjust some things. So anyway, you can adjust all of this yourself, but I'm going to copy this and just show you how it looks. So I will put it right below my other snippet there and save. Now notice the icon was before and the text is after. These have to be separate because they're separate classes. Now when I refresh the page, there should be text here. All right, and you can see it looks very nice. It says back to top. And we could even change, you know, the color of that. We could put color green or color hex color, whatever, right? And yeah, you can basically play around with those values. Right now, I feel like it looks nice. It might be nice to have some padding on the right side of the overall button. So to move on, style and position, I should have said the overall like back to top button, like the whole thing. So notice that this one is just targeting the whole thing. It's not targeting like after, right? It's not targeting before. It's just targeting the whole thing, the ETPB scroll top. So what it's doing here is basically targeting that overall button. And you can use things like the background color, add some padding, and you can also position it in from the edge if you want to. So we'll look here, it says right 20. That means it's going to say right side of the page, move in 20 pixels. And then border radius is 5, so it's going to have a little rounded corner. And the bottom, it's saying from the bottom of the page, I want it to be 125 pixels. So I'm going to paste this, and then I'll probably end up adjusting some values just to show you. So again, go into wherever you're putting your code and save. And we'll refresh one more time here. All right, so it moved in from the side. There's that 20 pixels to the right. Looks pretty nice. It also added the padding that we were needing on the right side. What I'm going to do now is just see, like, let's say bottom 25, and let's say right side 40. And let's say padding. Well, no, let's leave the padding. I'll up the border radius to 15. That'll be really obvious. So what I'm just showing you is like you can customize this, all these values. See, now it's going to be 25 pixels from the bottom, 40 pixels from the side, and it has rounded corners. All right, so you get the picture. Like you can really style that really nicely. Now for hover, I really recommend hover. Changing the color of the background would be like maybe the basics. I feel like that's something that you should do, because if I go to this and I hover over it, like nothing happens. So I don't really know. I mean, I know it's gonna click, but like it also should indicate it, right? So let's just do that one. And I just have background color. So I'll paste that in here just to give you that quick example of the background changing color when we hover. nice red. You could even add a box shadow like I do here. There's this little shadow that appears when you hover over it. Kind of makes it look like it's like, I don't know, going up, or I mean it is going up, but it's like it looks like it's three-dimensional a little bit. Anyway, there you go. That's how easy it is to customize that. It's really that easy. You can customize all this. Now, I also have this other tutorial that's kind of interesting. So you know how the back to top button shows up? It kind of shows up when you start scrolling down. Well, the thing that can happen, you may not want it to show up on each device. Maybe on desktop you have a really short page, and you know how when you go and shrink that down to like a phone size, technically the page gets super long. So just as an example, let's say you only wanted that button to show up on the long page. Like, sure, like maybe for you, like desktop is like this long. Like it's not a huge page, so you don't want that button showing up. You can actually decide which device you want it to show up. And I have the tutorial linked. It's a separate tutorial. So you can go over and check that out. It's one we did like a year ago or some other time. It's a completely separate tutorial. So that's, I wanted to let you know about that because it's all related. Now, I talked about doing this with a plugin. So this is using our Divi Assistant plugin. Now, this plugin has tons and tons of settings for Divi, making your life simpler with Divi. So instead of using code, it does all kinds of things that you can just enable settings. So you can kind of see from the screenshot what we're dealing with, just color pickers and drop downs, input fields, right? I will show you that. In fact, real quick, I'm going to delete the code so that we're not conflicting. I will go over to Divi Assistant and I will go to front end helper. And then there's a back to top button. And right here it says customize the back to top button. It explains what to do. And then you enable that. And right away you can see, oh, here's a drop down to choose which devices you want to show it on, what I just talked about. Oh, here I can set the back to top button color. For example, I will make it green. And the icon color I will make white. And what do you want the border radius to be? Well, 5, and distance from the right. Maybe I want it to be 30. How much from the bottom? Maybe I want it to be 55. And back to top button icon color, I want it to be orange. And some blue color for the hover. Now here, this drop down is nice because you can choose, do I want to have just an icon? Or do I want to have text, only text? Or do I want to have an icon and text? It's that simple. And then right here you can see the field. Remember where we were getting these icons from Elegant Themes? We can actually just put that icon in here now. So which one did I actually use? I guess I have short-term memory. 21. So as an example, I can say /21 right there. Right here I can say back to top, or I can say scroll up. And I can choose either left or right text. Just like that, I can hit save. I did not touch any code. And you can see the button, sorry. You can see the button is styled. It looks like I need to work on the padding and the hover color, and yeah, the orange and green is not working. You get the idea. I literally just did that with these settings. And it has all the settings you need here to do that. To me, that's easy. It's gonna be up to you. I can also export and import these settings so that on any new site, I can kind of have things configured the way I want. And of course we have hundreds of other settings. So there you go. I kind of like doing that where I can give you the two options. You wanna use code snippets? There you go. If you have our plugin, if you're a member of our Divi Adventure Club, we have a membership where you can get all of our products, including Divi Assistant. Well, then it kind of makes sense. I feel like it kind of makes sense if you already have our membership or you already have Divi Assistant to just enable a setting. But yeah, if you're kind of one of those people who you insist on using code and that's fine, then there you go. I cover both bases. So I hope you appreciate that. And if you do, definitely give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Please subscribe. That really helps. A lot of people just find my videos here and there. But if you're interested in Divi content, I do this every week, and that's what you'll get here on this channel. So we'll see you all in the next video.